What's going on, guys? Today I'm going to go through the Apex 365 workout. I know you might have saw Kaylin and Kellen go through it today. Kaylin went through the Ascent version, so if you have full gym, full equipment like we have in here at Apex, he went through that version. Kellen went through the base camp slash travel version. So I have a couple things I wanted to point out about today's workout and how I'm gonna attack it. So today I'm gonna do the travel program just with one set of 30-pound dumbbells. And now I know in the travel program it says if you have bands only to do the travel program, but I know a lot of you have been doing the travel program even though you have dumbbells, and that's totally fine. Travel is just meant if you only have one item of equipment. So if you only have bands, you can do travel. If you only have dumbbells, you can do travel, but you could also do base camp. So today I'm gonna go through the whole workout with one set of 30-pound dumbbells. Obviously, there's a lot of movements where 30-pound dumbbells are gonna be kind of light for me, so I'm gonna decrease rest to challenge myself still. There's some other movements that 30-pound dumbbells are gonna be pretty tough, especially come circuit three. So starting off with the Zercher squat is typically done holding a barbell across the forearms like you saw Kaylin today. But today, I'm just gonna do it with 30-pound dumbbells, like I said, racked up here like this, like you typically see for thruster squat. We got Zercher right down in the dumbbell alternating bench. I'm just gonna lay down on the ground and press one at a time. You could also do a standing shoulder press if you'd like to do that, although yesterday's workout had quite a bit of shoulder in it, so today there's not as much shoulder, hardly any. Skaters alternating V-up, great exercise to get the heart rate up. So for someone like myself that has access to only 30-pound dumbbells or that I'm sanctioning myself to for today, I can still challenge myself down here going hard on the skaters, right into alternating V-up, shorten the rest from 1 minute to 30 to 45 seconds, and then jump back again. So always keep that in mind. If you don't, oh, I don't have enough weight to make things hard for me, that's not a problem. You can still get a great workout in, get your movement in, keep the body going, keep the body healthy just by cutting rest and still doing it rather than doing nothing at all. Coming over here to circuit two, I'm gonna combine the single leg RDL with the dumbbell row. So again, 30-pound dumbbells aren't much of a challenge for me on the dumbbell row. Neither are they for single leg RDL. So I'm going to do the single leg RDL, hold, and do the row at the bottom of it. So it's gonna be a movement combined. One to two, one to two, one to two, back and forth. I'm gonna do eight on each side and then switch and do eight on the other, okay? So I'll get 16 rows in total, and then I'll get eight on each side here with the single leg RDL. Tuck jump, that's gonna be hard. 10 jumps right there is pretty tough. Right into dumbbell toe touch. And again, we like to add this ab activity or core exercise activity after getting the heart rate up and challenging the body through a few movements. So we've had three movements core, three movements core. A lot of people just do core by itself, which is good. It's better than doing nothing. But we'd like to have it here after the heart rate's up to challenge the body and get the body to learn to control the core still with the heart rate up. So these would be two good circuits right here to challenge myself. I'm gonna cut this rest from a minute down some. Down here, a lot of people, we've had some feedback on a lot of lower extremity work, and obviously with things like jumps, skaters, those are lower extremity. Those are just designed to get the heart rate up. But down here in circuit three, we have a bicep tricep circuit as opposed to something upper body and something lower body. These two movements typically can be looked at as meathead movements, as guys in the gym just wanting to work on their arms, but these do have good value in terms of shoulder protection, elbow protection, and wrist protection, especially for those of you that like golf, tennis, other recreational activities. These are great exercises right here. Right here for the wall ball, although I have the equipment in here to do wall ball, I'm gonna offer up a different variation. I'm gonna do a jumping jack with a press with these dumbbells. That's gonna be a little bit harder, something to still add weight going up, but I don't have the ball, or I'm not gonna use the ball in the workout today. Right into a Superman plank. This is probably the most challenging core exercise in this entire workout. You're having to support the whole body while elevating an arm and a foot at the same time. So I really like this one down here. Good shoulder stability exercise as well as challenge the core. Down here, the recovery. I'm gonna shorten the warm-up just so you can see a couple of my favorite warm-up movements before I like to start, especially if I'm gonna do an abbreviated workout, if I'm putting myself under a sanction of having little time. This is a way you can get the warm-up in and still enter into a full body workout safely without just diving right in and leading to any type of injury. So I'll do the expedited warm up, get into this like I mentioned, and then be sure to hit this recovery. Now, if you're challenged or stressed for time, be sure to get this recovery in at some point later in the day. I like to get it in twice, right after the workout, and then sometime in the evening just to help reset the body, minimize that onset soreness or muscles that tighten up or seize up, especially if you've been away from weights for a little while or training in general. You want to make sure you hit this recovery periodically just to minimize that soreness and allow your body the opportunity to recover a little bit more and be ready for another workout tomorrow. So let's get into this. I'm gonna move this cool little rolling wall out the way, clear out my space and get to it. Here we go. Get into this warm up. I'm gonna get my timer on. For those of you that don't already, be sure to challenge yourself and monitor yourself in terms of your rest, your heart rate. I like to use my Apple Watch for it. Some people like to wear a heart rate monitor and sync that to their phone, whichever you like. We have a timer over here on the wall. I actually like to put the timer up there. I've been accustomed my whole life playing sports to just looking up and seeing a clock. I don't really like looking down at my wrist. I like to check my heart rate out from time to time in between circuits, make sure it's coming down. But in general, I like to just keep it up here. However you like to do it, just be sure that you're timing yourself so you know how long you're resting and not taking too long of a rest, and then make sure you're not taking too long to do the whole workout in general. Also, you can measure improvement by decreasing rest time in between each round, in between the circuits, and throughout the whole workout in general. So there's a lot of different ways you can improve without going up in weight or band. Time is a big way to improve, so keep that in mind. Let's get started with this. You guys can follow along with me. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, here we go. This bad boy. All right, we're gonna get 1 minute. Just moving, get the blood flow going. I like to do about 30 seconds straight forward right here, and then 30 seconds lateral hop. Get the body going forward, back, as well as side to side. Right, 1 minute right there. My two favorite moves right here. Reverse lunge, twist both ways. Come up. Get 5 in on each leg. Switch it up. Second move I like, the monkey crawl. Get 3 on each side. All right, if you got a band, the band activation sequence is good to get into right here. I'm gonna go one time through each movement. Squat, pull apart, lateral step, right, left, diagonal pull apart each way, monster walk in place with a lat pull down chest fly. Should take about 2 minutes. We'll have a 5 minute warm up done real quick. Mm-hmm. Bands in, dynamic in. Let's get to it. All right, first circuit, Zercher squat. I'm gonna be holding them right here in the front rack position with the dumbbells. DB alternating bench, 8 each arm. Skaters, 8 each way. Alternating beat up, 8 each way. All right, here we go. Hey, if I lay down, can you see it still?
You gotta back up in line with the closer.
Box.
Right there.
Here we go. 10 piece. Go ahead. One down, 3 to go. Took 1 minute and 30 seconds. All right, coming up on 40 seconds rest. I'm gonna get into it again. Challenge myself a little bit. Here we go. Two down, 2 to go. What's up?
That's where you should be.
I hear. That's 30 seconds. All right, here we go. That's 40, we got 2 more. Let's do this. That's three. One more here, one more. Ten more seconds, we got 40 seconds. Last time through, let's do this. Good work. Woo! Circuit warm down. Let's go. Now I'm gonna take 2 minutes, two full minutes before circuit two. I wanna try to bring the heart rate down from where it's at right now. I'm at about 170. If you guys can see that. I wanna try to get this down to 120s, 130s. 2 minutes here. Now in this next circuit, we're gonna single leg RDL. Row, come up. I'm combining exercise one and two. We're gonna get 8 on each leg. So we'll end with 16 total rows. Remember I said these 30s right here are a little light for what I wanna row. So we're gonna double up the reps on the row and add 2 more to each leg on the single leg RDL. These two exercises work your posterior kinetic chain, so the muscle on the back side of your body. Some of the most important muscles that help keep your body upright and help minimize back pain, as well as shoulder and knee pain, secondly. So these two right here, great activities for you. Got 30 seconds, we're gonna start. 4 rounds here. Let's try to go with 40 seconds rest again. These tuck jumps are gonna be tough. 15 seconds. Circuit 2, 8 each leg, single leg RDL to a row to start. Here we go. Number 1. Thank you. That's one. Here we go. Number two. That's two. Two more. Two more rounds. Round three right here. One more. Here we go. Last time on this circuit. Two circuits down. Now we're gonna take 2 minutes. Let's bring that heart rate back down. Here's where I'm at, 170. 2 minutes. Now those of you in that last circuit might have noticed, as it went on, single leg RDL might have gotten harder with the balance. Moving through circuit one, circuit two, circuit three, circuit four. When you're talking about 12 reps, 20 reps, 30 reps, 42 reps minimum of work per circuit, after a while it's gonna add up. And what's great about that circuit is, not only are we getting that posterior kinetic chain work, the core work when we're tired, we're also working on balance as we get fatigued, which is huge. Big, big, widely overlooked component of training, especially amongst adults, especially amongst the athlete demographic, like myself, the former athletes that think in their head, oh, I have premier balance at one point in my life. That was at one point in your life. Probably not the same thing today. So it's always good to go back and address those things and fine tune those. We're gonna get into this third circuit now. We got dumbbell overhead tricep extension right here, 10. We got a hammer curl for 12. We got 3 rounds in a row here, no rest. This will get hard on the grip. If you're holding dumbbells like I'm going to be, the grip strength is gonna be challenged here. You'll feel the burn in the forearms. Fingers will start to fatigue. You'll wanna set these down. Challenge yourself to hold them the whole time for all 3 sets. You gotta take a break, hold them, take a break. Move slow, move under control. Let's bang this out. Here we go. We're at about 26 minutes right now. Total workout. We got a warm up and 2 circuits in. Let's get this third circuit in. Here we go. That's one. We got 2 more. I'm already burning a little bit this weight. Didn't challenge me in circuit 1 or 2. Circuit 3, this is some tough weight for me. Here we go. Whew. Whew, that's two. It's burning, it's burning. Forearms burning, biceps burning, triceps on fire. We got one more. Let's push through this, let's go. Five more. Woo, let's drop them. Shake it out. Tough circuit right there for me. Tough one. We're gonna go into this fourth circuit. Last one to work. Last one. Three times through. Wall ball. If you got a wall ball, high ceilings outside, great exercise for explosiveness, get the heart rate up. Now, I have a ball that I could use, but I'm gonna show you something you could do with just your dumbbells to still challenge you. Similar movement, we're not gonna get that pop and release with the ball, we're just gonna hold one dumbbell. So I got 30s, I'm gonna hold one 30 pound dumbbell. We're gonna do a jumping jack motion with it. So we got eight there. Superman plank, eight each arm. It's gonna be tough. Three rounds, 1 minute rest. When you get into that Superman plank, just know you might need to gather your breath. It's a slow controlled exercise. We're gonna get out. Boom, back and forth, eight on each side. 1 minute rest, three rounds, and we're done. We're going on 29 and a half minutes right now, total workout time. All right, 10 seconds, we'll get started. 10 seconds.
Yes.
Here we go. All right, number one, ready, go. One minute, two more. Seconds. 20 seconds. Now, if one round wasn't enough on that, add more reps to that jumping jack with the dumbbell raise. 5 seconds, round two. One more, 1 minute rest. 20 seconds. Last time. Hop into it now if you need to. If you need a little more rest, take that full minute. If you need more reps, get more reps in the jumping jack. Here we go. Last time. That's it. We made it. Here we are. Can you see this? Right here. Boom. Got the work in today. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for following along. Pause that wherever you need to. I'm gonna get the recovery in on my own. You guys go ahead, get it in now, and again later. Warm up if you need to later. Go through that warm up again. Even just the monkey crawl or the reverse lunge or the twist. Both good movements to open up the body, okay? Got some shoulder work in today. Just by holding that squat position with the dumbbells, and then that plank. Two ways that the shoulder got attention without strictly dedicating an exercise. A lot of good full body work today. If you're feeling it from yesterday and today, feel free to recover tomorrow. Take a day off. Remember, your body can only be pushed as much as you're gonna recover. So that includes sleep, that includes nutrition, that includes hydration. So don't neglect those three things and then expect yourself to be able to do this style of workout as hard as you can 6 days in a row, okay? Recover, keep pushing, keep sharing. Let's all keep getting better. See you soon.